Depression involves more than the nervous system. For a long time, the physiology of depression has been of great interest to researchers. They've been looking for biomarkers that can give us some kind of test to diagnose depression. They've also been interested in how and why depression often co-occurs with other chronic conditions. What we see in these reports is that as the nervous system changes, there are changes in many, multiple systems through the body. So where this all starts is with an imbalance between the sympathetic and the parasympathetic systems. We have too much of that go, go, go sympathetic energy in our body, and not enough of that soft, flexible ventral vagal response. What this leads to is what's called loss of heart rate variability. Our heart rate is constantly changing. It responds to the environment. So if I'm lying in bed in the morning and I need to get up, I'm thinking about getting up, my heart rate will actually speed up a little bit. The sympathetic nervous system will take charge and give me the energy and the motivation to become upright and to move and to grab my dressing gown and do the things that I need to do in the morning. Similarly, when we're facing something that like a safe, comfortable situation, our heart rate will slow down. It will be moderated by that ventral vagal system, and it will cue that it's all right. We don't need a lot of go, go, go energy. So when we are out of balance in this way, when we have too much sympathetic and adrenaline system going on in our body, then we have less flexibility in our cardiac response. We're less flexible in response to the environment around us. What also happens is we get an increased blood sugar, blood pressure, and blood sodium levels. So just take a moment to think about the health implications of that, of your blood sugar, your blood pressure, and your blood sodium increasing, even though the body systems that control them are not telling them to do so. Our hypothalamic pituitary adrenal HPA axis becomes activated. The HPA axis is our hormonal stress response system. So our sympathetic nervous system is a fast-acting, fast-finishing way of creating a stress response in the body. But when the HPA axis gets involved, this is a much more longer lasting production. There's production of adrenaline as a hormone so that it takes its time developing in the body, and also the production of cortisol. Both of these substances circulate in the body and they create long-term stress response. This also leads to a dysregulation of the immune system and what's called a pro-inflammatory state. Inflammation in the body is the precursor of many illnesses. There's also a change in the tryptophan kynurenine pathway, and that leads to inflammation and the production of neurotoxins. What we're saying then is that psychological, neural, immune and hormonal changes happen in the body as a result of this imbalance between the sympathetic and the parasympathetic. And they happen little by little on a curve. If it's allowed to continue, they develop into a disease state. The type of disease varies, but the possibilities studied so far include depression, cardiovascular disease, and type 2 diabetes. I point this out because so often people with depression hear that it's all in their head, that it's not a real disease, that they just need to buck up and get over it. But you would never say that to somebody with type 2 diabetes or with cardiovascular disease. And depression follows the same pattern of development as these two other chronic illnesses. All of them result from chronic stress. The disease which develops depends on the individual, on their genetic inheritance, and the type of life stressors that they faced. This is the work of a group of systems biologists in Australia. They've identified the actual network of processes in the body which maintain an ongoing moment-by-moment balance of acidity, sugar, oxygen, and all other necessary factors. They present compelling evidence that this entire network changes when disease is developing. It's not just a single system involved. The components of this network are the central nervous system, the autonomic nervous system, the immune system, the endocrine system, and the gut. Specifically, how material moves through the gut, how permeable the gut is, what it allows in and out of our bodies, and the microbiome, the little organisms, bacteria that are living inside of our guts and helping us to digest. These biologists, their names are Stapleton, Newman, and Shum at Griffith University in Queensland, propose that there's a gradual transition from good health to disease, and that this can be reversed if good treatment and a reduction in stress can be offered in time. That's what we need to focus on, both as therapists and as people who are living with depression. We need to make the connection between stress and the symptoms of depression, and we need to work to reverse this dangerous trend in the body. So just a reminder, all of this results from a skewed balance in the nervous system, from too much sympathetic activation and not enough low threat, low ventral vagal response.